Cursor is absolutely killing it right now with the launch of version 1.0. Now, this isn't your average coding tool anymore. It's built to make your workflow smoother and help your business to grow without unnecessary complications. So imagine your team shipping better products, moving faster, and staying focused on what actually matters to your vision. And the best part is that it works with the setup that you already have, so there's no extra effort required. But what makes it different? Well, unlike tools like Codex, Cursor 1.0 is smarter and more in tune with how real projects evolve. It supports the way you build instead of forcing you to adjust. Welcome to Plevo Deep Dive. I'm Caleb Friesen, your host, and today we're going to be diving into the exciting features that are there in this brand new Cursor 1.0 and basically looking at what it brings to the table. So this is their official announcement. First up, we have BugBot. It automatically reviews your pull requests and flags potential bugs or issues before they slip through. Now, when an issue pops up, like a subtle logic flaw in your code, BugBot drops a clear, actionable comment right on your GitHub pull request. It helps you to catch problems early on, saving time and keeping your code cleaner. And so for devs, that means faster turnaround and fewer distractions. And for businesses, it leads to quicker launches, fewer bugs reaching users, and lower maintenance costs as well. And with one click, you can open Cursor's editor with a pre-filled fix prompt, so you're not wasting time switching tools or starting from scratch. Now, setting it up is pretty straightforward, but there are a couple of things that you'll need. Firstly, make sure that you have admin access on both Cursor and your GitHub organization, and then head over to cursor.com/settings and go to the integrations tab and then click on connect GitHub. And if you've already connected it before, then just hit manage connections. And then after that, just follow the GitHub flow to install the app. Now, once that's done, come back to the integrations tab and turn on BugBot for the repos that you want. And from there, you can tweak the settings to fit your workflow. Now, you can also set up a monthly spending limit for this. For pro users, you can set up BugBot in USD and the cost will count towards your global spending limit. And then once you've installed it on GitHub, you'll see a list of available installations along with their enabled repositories. And you can turn BugBot on or off for each repo individually. And one thing to note here is that BugBot only runs on your personal pull requests. And for team users, the team admin can set a monthly spending limit in USD. So after installation, team admins will see a list of GitHub installations and their enabled repositories. They can enable or disable BugBot for each repo and manage allow or deny lists for reviewers. And so once BugBot is enabled, it'll run on pull requests from anyone contributing to those repositories, whether they're on your team or not. And then now the next feature that I want to talk about here is a background agent for everyone. So a couple of weeks ago, they released a remote coding agent in early access and got great feedback. And so now they've expanded it to all users. You can start using it right away by clicking the cloud icon in chat or pressing Command E on Mac or Control E on Windows if you have privacy mode turned off. But this feature is currently available only for users with privacy mode disabled. They're still working on support for users who have privacy mode enabled. Now, the next feature is especially useful for data scientists, researchers, and teams that rely heavily on data to make decisions. So Cursor can now make actual changes inside of Jupyter Notebooks using agents. And this is a big upgrade because until now, working with Jupyter in Cursor was limited to basic edits without smooth AI-driven support. But with this update, agents can now create and edit multiple cells directly inside of Jupyter Notebooks, making complex workflows much smoother. It's a solid upgrade for research and data science. And right now it only works with Sonnet models. So for developers, this means faster iteration on data analysis or machine learning tasks without the need to manually manage each cell. Now, the next update is also pretty important because I've seen other models struggle with maintaining context across projects a lot, but now Cursor has improved memory and context handling. It can remember key details from your conversations and bring them up when relevant. And these memories are stored per project on an individual basis and can be managed in your settings. It's currently in beta, so To start using it, head over to Settings, enable the feature, and then select Rules to customize how it actually works. Okay, so next up is the MCP OneClick Install with OAuth support. Now, this one's a pretty big deal, especially if you've ever tried setting up MCP servers in VS Code. It can be pretty complex with all of the manual configuration and frustrating auth errors, but now it's all handled with a single click. Cursor even gives you a curated list of MCP servers that you can actually add instantly, making it super easy to plug powerful tools into your workflow. But let's take a look at what's available here. So this MCP server list includes some seriously useful integrations that can make every part of your workflow feel more connected and efficient. You've got Notion to sync up project docs, Figma to stay connected to your design workflows, and Linear to keep task updates flowing. Then there's GitHub, which helps automate pull requests and commits, while Stripe simplifies working with payment APIs, Playwright steps in for automating testing, Atlassian brings in Jira support to manage development workflows, and Sentry keeps track of errors before they turn into user complaints. Now, if you're a developer, you can also create an add to cursor button for your own MCP server and drop it into your docs, making it easy for others to install and adopt across teams. They've also improved chat responses here too. So cursor can now display visualizations right inside of conversations, such as these mermaid diagrams that you can see here, and can also generate and display markdown tables right within the conversation, keeping everything that you need in one place. So whether it's diagrams or tables, cursor is making it easier to visualize complex information without switching contexts. And then finally, there are new settings and dashboards too. With the new dashboard, you can easily track your personal or team usage, update your display name, and see detailed stats broken down by tool or model. So whether you're a solo developer looking to simplify your coding or a founder focused on delivering better products faster, this update offers tools to help you get there. But what do you think of Cursor 1.0? Are you planning to try it in your workflow? Drop a comment down below and let me know which feature stands out to you. Which one are you most excited about? Or share your experience if you're already using it. And if you found this video interesting, then do like and subscribe for more content like this. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.